In that place, there also lived this girl who was tormented by Satan. That filthy spirit, you see, would often appear to her in the form of a dragon and swallow her whole. He sucked so much blood from her, in fact, that she looked just like a corpse. Every time she would come to her senses, she would hold her head in her hands and scream, "How wretched I am, seeing how there is none to save me from this wicked dragon." Her father and mother cried for her and lamented, as did all the others there. And all who were there would feel particularly bad for her whenever they would hear her weeping, wailing, and crying out, "Oh, my friends! Oh, my family! Is there no one who can save me from this murderer?" The prince's daughter, whose leprosy had completely vanished, upon hearing the wailing of that girl, went all the way up to the roof of her palace and saw the girl's hands wrapped around her head, surrounded by her sorrowful companions, and pouring forth a stream of tears. She then asked the possessed girl's husband if his mother-in-law were living, and he let her know that both her mother and her father were indeed alive. Then she had the girl's mother sent to her, and as she caught sight of her approach, she asked her mother, "Is this possessed girl here your daughter?" "Yes, young lady," she woefully and sorrowfully confessed. "I was the one who gave birth to her." The prince's daughter then replied, "Tell me all about her state, because I am here to tell you that I once had a skin disease, but the Lady Mary, the mother of Jesus Christ, healed me of it. If you'd like to see your daughter cured, then take her to Bethlehem and ask to see Mary, the mother of Jesus, and have no doubts as to whether your daughter will recover. For I believe with all my heart that you will go back home rejoicing over your daughter's restoration." And when she had finished speaking, she got up and took her daughter there. Then she went up to Mary and shared her girl's circumstances with her. And when she had listened to her story, Mary gave the woman some of the water that she had used to wash off the body of her boy Jesus and asked her to pour it over that of her daughter. She also gave her one of the swaddling cloths of the Lord Jesus, saying, "Take this cloth and show it to your adversary every time that you see him." And she bade them peace and sent them off. After leaving that town and returning home, the hour that Satan would typically show up and take control of her came around. The accursed spirit suddenly showed himself to her in the likeness of an enormous dragon. On seeing this, the girl was terrified, but her mother said, "Daughter, have no fear, but allow him to draw near to you. Then reveal to him the swaddling cloth that was given to us by Our Lady Mary, and let us see what comes of it." Then Satan approached her in the form of a terrifying dragon, and the girl became so afraid that she began to tremble with violence. But even as she held the swaddling cloth to her head and about her eyes, where the dragon could see it, flames shot out, and the dragon was pummeled with fiery cinders. What a wonder was brought about through all that had happened, for just as soon as the dragon caught sight of the swaddling cloths of the Lord Jesus, fire shot out of it and bespattered his eyes and face. "Why should you and I meet like this, Jesus, son of Mary?" he shrieked loudly. "Where am I to run and free myself from you?" So he fled away from her in fear. She, being freed from her torment, sang songs of praise and thanks to God, along with everyone else who was there at the time that this miracle took place.